Hey there. Subscribe to my channel. And also press this bell icon. So you never miss any new updates, cause whenever we upload new video you will get a notification on your phone.
Hello everyone, today we will talk about password recovery of a Cisco router. If you forget the password of your Cisco router, so don't worry, there's a process of recovery of it. First, I'm taking a router. Coming to the configuration of CLI of this router. As we can say that we are accessing a router as user mode, so I'm enabling the privilege mode, and then I'm going to the configuration, global configuration mode. So I am here putting a password to this router so that no one can access this. So as unknown person, I put it a random password. So to be very honest, I myself don't know what I have put it here. So I'm writing these two NVRAM, which is non-volatile RAM. So this setting will be permanently saved to the router, whether you turn on or off, this will be stored here. So at this stage, I don't know the password, and if I exit that privilege mode, then this will be a problem for me to accessing this router. So I'm going back to the user mode. Now as a user, if I'm accessing this will ask me to password. Now I don't know the password, and the data is already written on the NVRAM, non-volatile low random access memory. So what to do next? If you don't know the password, or a member of your company left the office without telling you the password, so there is a process of password recovery. So what to do next? What I'm trying to access is version details of this router. So if you can see that there is a many things coming up, maybe the links or router number and version and companies and etc. So from this instruction, I need a register. Here it is. Configuration register. So register, as we can see that as we know, the register is a small memory that is located near to the processor that can help for saving data. So my passwords are stored in this register, and there is a number 0x2102. So this register is responsible for saving password in your settings. So I just need to change this register or replace this register or access this. So how to do this? I'm going here and I'm just turning off my router from physical part of this. So I'm restart it again. So when it is restarting, it is showing a waiting process. So in this waiting process, you have to press the Control C button. As I press the Control C button, you can see that I am on boot mode of the router. In this boot mode, we already know that when we are installing the Windows, there is a BIOS basic input output unit. So it is something similar to that BIOS in the computers. So I'm telling the router that configure register 0x2102. So what I'm doing is actually telling the router that this register 0x2102 is password protected, so I'm not able to access this. So change this to something else, and this is user defined. I'm telling the router that use this register 0x2142 instead of 0x2102. So this is something new that I have defined. This is user defined. So we will use this route register to access the password. So I need to restart it or reset this router. So there are different commands on the real environment. For what I am using, it is reset. So the router is restored now. Let it restart. Don't interrupt in this section. When I access this, this will be a new router as we reset the old one and I change the register. So when I come here, the user mode, as we can see that I'm getting to the privilege mode and global configuration mode. There's no password there because the register are changed. So I'm going back and showing the running configuration. Running configuration is what we are doing on the router. This will show you. So there is nothing because it's new. I'm here checking the startup configuration. Startup configuration is the setting which we have done in the startup menu or mini iOS or BIOS or boot menu. So here we can see that the password is showing. This one is set up as in a startup configuration earlier someone. So here we have two solutions. The first one is that we can copy this password and use this as we are continuing. And the second one is we need to change this because we are new user and we need to set up our own company password. So I'm going to change this password to my new password. Furthermore, there are two types of password protection. The first one is the showing up as like the previous, and you can encrypt your password as well. So we will learn about this later. So I'm going to configuration mode and telling the router that no enable password, enable, and I'm setting the new password, which is Cisco. I remove the old one and set up a new password as Cisco. So I'm writing this on NVRAM. The data will not be lost when I turn off. So coming to the back, and I'm checking this running configuration. Here I can see that it's telling me you have changed your password to Cisco. So I'm going to the startup configuration, and as I can see that there is the same setting as on the running configuration. So if there is a no write command given on the privilege mode, you can directly copy the information coming from running configuration to startup configuration by typing running configuration and startup configuration. So this command will copy the entire data of running configuration to startup configuration. Press enter will tell you the name and press again enter. So this will be right. So configuration is builded successfully. So all the data on the running configuration is copied to the startup configuration. So we have same data on the both configuration panels, and the password is changed to Cisco. So I'm going to the configuration mode and telling the router that config register what I put it earlier 0x2102. So I'm changing the router to the default as given in the version as earlier. So I don't need to 0x2142 now because running configuration and startup configuration is same. So I'm writing these changes to router. Okay, I'm going to the physical section of the router and just need to restart it. So this will automatically switch to the register back to my default setting as I started earlier. That will be register number 0x2102. Okay, coming to the user mode, I'm just enabling the privilege mode. When I press the enter, this will definitely ask me to enter password. So what I need is just put a Cisco, CISCO, and here I am. So the access is granted because I have copied all the running configuration to startup and changes the register and back to my default register, and I am here with access. So there is no routing, there is no predefined configuration is deleted, nothing is changed, but just a password is accessed. So here I can see that my register is back to the default version or default number. In addition to this, if someone put a password which is encrypted form, so how to put that, we will learn about that. So first we need to enable password, remove the old one, and I'm just putting the new one with a secret. So here the text secret is inputted because you want to encrypt your password. The password is same, Cisco CISCO, and I put the secret word here so no one can see my password in encrypted form. I'm going back to the privilege mode and checking. Need to write this and checking the running configuration. So here we can see that the password CISCO is converted into encrypted form and showing something else. So if a man sitting next to you cannot see that what is your password, so this is higher level of security, and you can use this. Hope you guys understand the password recovery procedure of a Cisco router, and thanks for watching the video. Please don't forget to subscribe, like, comment, share, and if you have any query, please write below. Thank you.